currently serving as an emeritus professor in Monash University, that's in Melbourne, Australia. She's a prolific writer with over 200 publications so far and counting, including several in science. And she's instrumental in bringing the magic of dinosaurs to Singapore. So those of us who remember Sue, the T-Rex exhibition in Science Centre, yeah, that's a collaboration with Prof of NUS and Science Centre itself. And she's a close friend of the museum. She has donated quite a number of specimens here. If you visit our gallery at the live section, 5 of the specimens are from her. We also have in our collection a taxidermized koala. So without further ado, let's welcome Prof Rich.
I'm glad to see as many of you here tonight. Now the title is a little different because tomorrow we're going to put flesh on the bones, but I want to show you the bones and where everything came from. So sorry about the title being slightly different, but that's where we are. And you and I are very important. So what we're going to do, I'm going to narrow it down a little bit. I'm not going to talk about everybody's dinosaurs. I'm just going to talk about my husband who sits back there with his black shirt on, the dinosaur on the front of it, sorry. And I and our team of over 1,000 people in the last 30 years have worked on the dinosaurs from Australia. And the dinosaurs from Australia are kind of special from the area that we work in, not just because they're my dinosaurs and our dinosaurs, but because they're polar dinosaurs. When they were alive, Australia was really, really far south. And so it was really, really cold. And these dinosaurs were the toughest of the lot that lived. So our question has always been, well, why did they go extinct if they were so tough? Because climate change did occur at the end of the Cretaceous, about 65, 61 million years ago. And things were pretty rough. There were volcanoes all over the place in Western India. There were meteorites coming in and crashing. And it really wasn't a very pleasant place right at the end of what we call the Cretaceous. And so we have been very curious as we've worked on these dinosaurs for the last 30 years as to why they were able to live in the toughest of conditions on Earth, why they died out. And it just tells us that things must have been pretty awful at that time. So what I want to do tonight is three things. One, I'm going to give you a bit of a lecture, and I'm going to try not to bore you completely. So if I'm boring you, you just say, "You're really boring," and then I'll change and dance or something. But I also want to start out giving you an idea of how tough it has been to get these dinosaurs. I'm not going to necessarily show you the toughest of them. Tomorrow, if you come to the workshop that I'm giving, I will show you a documentary that really shows you we had to go underground. We had to develop a mine. We had to use explosives. We had to use underground drills. And we were just a bunch of people that never had done this before, but we learned how. And two of the people here that I was talking to, these two young men, were looking at the little thing over there that's making light. And it's a little, very special glass piece that was made in Sweden by a very famous glass maker. There's only about 3 of those made. And it is made by a company called Atlas Copco, which is a mining equipment company. And the reason that there is an Atlas Copcosaurus, and there is that piece of wonderful glasswork with Atlas Copcosaurus in it, is because they provided us all the underground drills, all the air legs, all of the mining equipment that we needed for 30 years they still provided to us. And so we thought it was about time that we said thank you. So we did. We named it Atlas Copcosaurus. And they are so proud of that dinosaur that we went to visit them in Sweden last year. They made a dinosaur that they can dress up in and run around in the streets. They have made all manner of things, and they really are proud of this. They're proud of what they did. So anyway, that will come out. But first of all, I want to show you where the first dinosaur in Australia was found, and it is a short documentary, and I'll show you another documentary towards the end that's very short too. And this one gives you an idea where that first dinosaur was found, and where we first started more than 30 years ago looking for more and more dinosaurs, and it was graduate students, or students, undergraduate students at a university that found the first ones after one was found in 1903, and then in 1977, was it called?
Eight.
1978, these students started finding